It's time for DuBois Beaver High School football in Bigfoot. Realty of DuBois, Tri-County Performance, DuBois, Joe's Tuck Shop in DuBois, DuBois Drug and Wellness, DuBois Regional Cardiology Associates, Brian Leach, Real Estate Agent of DuBois, and Bloom Electric Heating, Plumbing, and Air Conditioning, DuBois Beavers High School football is on in Bigfoot Country.
Hi, it's Mike from DeLulo Transport in DuBois. We have immediate openings for local package delivery drivers for our FedEx division. These are non-CDL driving positions. Applicants must be 21 years old, able to lift 100 pounds, have a professional appearance, and must pass a drug test. DeLulo Transport is big enough to deliver, but small enough to care. To apply or find out more, stop by our office at 349 DuBois Street or give us a call at 814-503-4131.
Want to start your day like a king? Visit DuBois Burger King for a hot and delicious sausage or bacon, egg, and cheese croissantwich. Get two for just $4. Rise and shine with a croissantwich that's made with 100% butter, piled with savory sizzling sausage or thick naturally smoked bacon, fluffy eggs, and melted American cheese. Visit DuBois Burger King today and grab two for just $4 to start your day like a king. DuBois Burger King on Route 255 in DuBois.
Welcome to the DeLulo Transport pregame show, sponsored by DeLulo Transport, a family-owned and operated company providing reliable transportation services with headquarters in DuBois. I'm Jeff Hunter, and it is playoff football for the DuBois Beavers in the 2021 season as they take on the University Prep Wildcats. The Beavers, of course, finished the regular season with a 5-5 record. They qualified for the playoffs a few weeks back, but this is going to be a much different opponent for the Beavers as they're taking on a team from inner city Pittsburgh. DuBois will have the advantage playing at home at Mansell Stadium, but anything can happen under Friday night lights. The interesting thing about University Prep, however, is that they qualified for the playoffs with a losing record, finishing their season only 2-5. And we'll take a closer look at University Prep after this word from DeLulo Transport.
Hi, it's Mike from DeLulo Transport in DuBois. We have immediate openings for local package delivery drivers for our FedEx division. These are non-CDL driving positions. Applicants must be 21 years old, able to lift 100 pounds, have a professional appearance, and must pass a drug test. DeLulo Transport is big enough to deliver, but small enough to care. To apply or find out more, stop by our office at 349 DuBois Street or give us a call at 814-503-4131.
Welcome back to the DeLulo Transport pregame show. As I mentioned, this game is not quite a typical playoff game as University Prep enters the playoffs with a losing record. They finish their season only 2-5, which is kind of an interesting position to find themselves in. Their two wins came against Sharon and Perry Traditional Academy, but all of their losses aside from one game have been very, very close, so their record is not quite what it seems on paper. The challenge for the Beavers is that University Prep is unlike any other team they've faced this season with a completely different style of football, and that could definitely throw them off going into this game. But overall, the Beavers were the much better team during the regular season, and they should have the advantage just based on that reason alone. It's playoff football in DuBois tonight at Mansell Stadium, and that wraps up the DeLulo Transport pregame show. Stay tuned for the Burger King of DuBois coaches show, where Devin Clark is standing by with head coach TJ Wingard.
Are you happy in your current job? Maybe just thinking it's time for a change? Then why not work for a company that actually cares about you? DeLulo Transport's looking for professional Class A drivers and owner-operators. Local drivers get home every day, and regional drivers are home through the week and every weekend, and can earn over $80,000 in wages and benefits. DeLulo Transport is big enough to deliver, but small enough to care. Stop by our office at 349 DuBois Street, give us a call at 814-503-4131, or find us at DeLuloTransport.com.
It's playoff time in DuBois. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the Burger King Coaches Show. Devin Clark here, as always, head coach TJ Winger, and we are getting ready for semifinal football, district semifinal football, Mansell Stadium, Friday night, for the first time since 2011, welcoming in the University prep out of the Inner City League District 8. So, Coach, let's get into it. So I want to know just right off the bat, you know, this being the first time in your short career as head coach, entering the playoffs, being playoff eligible, you got a 5-5 squad, had a really good script this year, really good football. So how are you feeling about the playoffs?
I think it's, number one, awesome for the kids. They've earned their way here. And at this stage throughout the week so far, we're just treating it as another game to prep for. It starts Friday night of last week, starting to break down film of what we did well, what we need to work on from the Karnes City game, and just work on, you know, the film that we have on university prep, and just working throughout the week and trying to fine-tune our game for this Friday.
Yeah, and we know how this season went. Now, I've started out 0-3. These kids really turned it around, had a five-game winning streak during the season to get playoff eligible, dropped our last two. We already heard from your standpoint, you know, where you're at in your head, so let's dive in, you know, your guys, what do they have to do to prepare for this first playoff game? Because there's not a lot of experience there in the playoffs.
No, I think it's, as I said, we're trying to treat this as, you know, it's week 11. It's an extra game. It's bonus football for us. Everyone is 0-0. And, you know, the game plan is set both offensively and defensively, and it's about executing it in practice and putting that on the field. Our goal is to play physical, to dictate to them how that game's going to go. And I think our kids are up to the task. Like I said, they deserve to be there, and we're going to go get it.
Yeah, and, you know, how are these guys responding, you know, to this challenge? Because, you know, there's a lot of, you know, things lingering with this playoff game. You know, it's been a while since we've been in. It's been since 2017. Since 2011 was the last home game that DuBois has hosted a playoff game. So, you know, do these kids understand that, and are they ready to accept this challenge?
Yeah, they talked about it in the preseason in August that, you know, the goal was to get into the district playoffs and do some damage. And so you can throw everything else out the window. That was on their main goal sheet, and they're here and have the opportunity to do it. The big thing for them and for us as a team is just to block out the outside noise. And, you know, okay, it is the first game, you know, playoff game in so many years, and the first one at home. And the
Thank you. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. On behalf of the DuBois Area School District and the District 9 Athletic Committee, we welcome you to DuBois at E.J. Mansell Stadium for tonight's District 8-9 4A sub-regional semifinal round football game between the University Prep Panthers and our DuBois Area Beavers. The winner of tonight's game will advance to District 6-8-9 sub-regional championship game to be played at a site and time to be determined. Regardless of the outcome of tonight's contest, we ask that all spectators consider the time and effort each of these participants have put forth to represent their school. The purpose of this activity is to provide positive learning experiences and opportunities for personal growth for the participants, cheerleaders, officials, and spectators. All are expected to assist in the promotion and achievement of good sportsmanship ideals by taking personal responsibility for their behavior. Remember, sportsmanship, the only missing piece is you. In the event of an emergency where we need to evacuate, we ask that you please locate the nearest exit. Emergency exits located on the ground level on each side of the stadium, on both the visitor and home side. Please exit quickly and calmly following an announcement. Our security and event staff are available throughout the stadium to assist in the evacuation. We would ask that you please proceed to your vehicles or near a safe place in the event of a weather-related incident, and we urge you to stay clear of trees, tents, or any metal structure. And as always, if you see something, say something. Now, would you please stand and, gentlemen, remove your hats as we honor America with the playing of our national anthem and the alma mater by the DuBois Area High School Band under the direction of Mrs. Melinda Swager.
First playoff game in quite a long time here at E.J. Mansell Stadium. The regular season's done. That season's over. We can put it in the books and look forward to playoff football.
Yeah, brand new season starts tonight, postseason. Just feels great to be back here. DuBois back in it, ready to get after it against University Prep tonight. So let's talk about them, get into USO. And when I say USO, they do a co-op as well. Three total schools from the inner city, Pittsburgh. District 8 is where they're from. University Prep, SciTech, and Obama Academy put together about a 50-man roster, bringing to Mansell Stadium tonight. And, you know, they present a challenge tonight that the Beavers haven't seen. You know, they got some athletes on the outside. They got a size advantage. And if DuBois doesn't play sound football, not very disciplined on the back end, could be a long night, and they could give up some points.
Yeah, even though they come in with a 2-5 record, I don't think you can really predicate how good this football team is. Looking at them in pregame warmups, they definitely have a size advantage over the Beavers. So we're going to have to play well to win this game tonight.
Yeah, on paper, looking at the records, you know, DuBois obviously favored, but it's not that way. When this USO team does score, they do score points. They only average 13 points a game. They've only played 7 as well. But, no, it's interesting with this team because they can score points, but they can give up points as well. They've been shut out 3 times this year. You know, like I said, their schedule's, you know, kind of different from most others, but DuBois hasn't played a team like this before. They play a certain brand of football, and it'll be a big challenge for the Beavers tonight.
I'm looking forward to it, Devin.
Absolutely. You know, looking at the Beavers here, 5-5 coming in. 5-4 they finished in the league play. And it's, like we mentioned, the first time that they've been in the playoffs since 2017. So we're about ready for kickoff here. We're just going to keep it right here. Continue a little pregame talk. DuBois lost the toss. USO decided to defer to the second half. DuBois will receive. So lots on the line here tonight. Talk to Coach Wingard right before game time. His final thoughts were, you know, these kids have the right mentality for this one. They put 3 good practices together to prepare. They're excited for the opportunity. They know it's at stake, and they're ready to accept this challenge here. And we are ready for playoff football here at Mansell. Here we go, John. Burkett and Benjamin back deep. Lock the doors, close the gates. Playoff football underway at Mansell. Taken by Burkett at the 10. Brings it across the 20. Cuts back to the 25, and he'll be wrestled down by Terrell Allen Tooks. John, it's a name I was talking about. I wanted to say all night long, get it early here. He has the special team stop. 1st and 10 for the Beavers on their own 27-yard line.
Yeah, I know that's a name you've been looking forward to saying all night long.
Plays linebacker for this team. I'm sure we'll be hearing it plenty. Cameron is the junior getting the start tonight. Keys for this DuBois offense, as always, stay on schedule, ball control. And the guys around Cameron Hayes have got to make plays. Here we go. Going to have a pre-snap penalty right off the bat. Came out in the jumbo package. 3 guys in the backfield. One of the up backs moved.
Yeah, Austin Henry gave a little twitch.
So DuBois starting in the wrong direction. And, you know, like we said, John, coming in 2-5 is this USO squad. You know, kind of deceiving of, you know, kind of the year they had and exactly how good this team is and how they match up against the Beavers tonight.
Yeah, these first few drives will tell a lot.
Absolutely. 4-2 defense. Third back through is Adams, and he's going nowhere on 1st and 15. First guy to him was Davin Griffin. No gain on the play.
Good push by the defensive line. Matt Adams right there in the backfield.
Yeah, Ben, it's no surprise that DuBois is coming out, going after the run game. That was the game plan for Coach Wingard. Wants to control the clock, control the line of scrimmage, keep his team on the field, defense resting. 2nd and 15, they're going to give it to Burkett coming around the edge, and he's not going to get anywhere. This is going to be a fast defense they're going against, so those perimeter plays might not be there. Loss of about 1 on the play. It's going to be 3rd and 16.
Yeah, he was eyeing that. The spy, great speed on the corner there, just cut him off.
That was once again Davin Griffin coming from a safety spot to make that play. 3rd and 16. Trips to the right for Cameron Hayes. He rolls to the right, looking, throws, has a man, and it's incomplete. Little behind Dinkfelt, would have been short of the marker. DuBois goes nowhere on the first possession of the 2021 postseason. 4th and 16, they're going to punt.
Well, hopefully on this chess match, we can start to gain field position. That's going to be big early in this game.
Hopefully they get the jitters out, you know, that first drive. You know, it's been a while. This is a new experience for these kids, you know. They've turned their things around in this program. These kids have seen both the losing end and winning sides of things. So probably some jitters tonight, and hopefully they're out of the way. Defense is coming out as Dingfels' punt is a good one. High end over ender, and they're going to let it bounce, and it's going to take a bounce. It's picked up, breaks one tackle, and another coming to the sideline to the 40, and eventually brought down. Still going, and no, they're going to call him out of bounds. Out of bounds. It was Daniel Kane who looked like he was going to let it bounce right to him. He picked it up and made something out of it, about a 25-yard return into Beaver territory. So we'll take a quick break on the change of possession. DuBois defense coming out 0-0, 10:26 to go first quarter. Listening to high school football on Bigfoot Country.
DuBois Beavers High School football in Bigfoot Country is brought to you by Joe's Tuck Shop DuBois. When you need to look your best, just go to Joe's. See all the homecoming specials. Proud supporter of the DuBois Beavers. DuBois Drug and Wellness. Your community, your health, your pharmacy. Proud supporter of the DuBois Beavers. DuBois Regional Cardiology Associates with locations in Clearfield, DuBois, Brookville, St. Mary's, and Punxsutawney. Proud to support our local student athletes. And by McDonald's of DuBois. Get McDelivery on the DoorDash app and get all your favorites delivered right to your door. McDonald's of DuBois, proud sponsors of DuBois Beavers High School football.
Welcome back to E.J. Mansell Stadium. First 10 key on Brooks. Back to Pax, and he's dropped by Justin Bankovich for a loss of 7. So a good first down play for the Beavers defense. Second and 17. Justin Bankovich with the sack. Three receivers to the right on second and 17. They're going to hand it up the middle, huge hole midfield, and that's going to be a first down.
Big hole up the middle. Don't need to plug that hole real quick.
So the big play by Justin Bankovich is negated. Paul Levy, the ball carrier, gets 18 on second down, moves it into Beaver territory, 39-yard line, first and 10. So we know where it starts defensively up front, and the linebackers, Justin Bankovich and Christian Kirk. Bankovich letting his presence known. First down, straight ahead. Well defended this time by DuBois. Picks up about 4 off the left side. It was Helvey, Paul Helvey, the ball carrier once again.
Good defensive play. Just fell forward for 4 yards.
Yep, and scouting this team, Coach Wingard informed me that, you know, they run first. They like to try to establish a line of scrimmage, but they do have athletes on the outside, and they like to take shots. They like to run verticals. If you can't defend them, it'll be tough. Second and 6. Brooks in the shotgun, and he's going to follow his up back and right into Justin Bankovich. Gets a couple up to about the 28. It's going to be 3rd down and 3 upcoming. So let's see if the DuBois defense can get an early stop here. USO driving.
This will be a good loss of yardage play. Good time for it.
Evenly sized for the most part, looking at both fronts of these team. 3 receivers to the right on 3rd down. Brooks back to pass. Heavy pressure fires. Got a man in its cleat. Or is it?
He dropped it.
Nope, now there's a late incomplete call. It was intended for Amir McLeod. Had it initially, but couldn't control it all the way. Going to bring up a 4th down, 4th and 3. Yeah, DuBois a little fortunate there. Gets a break and a chance to get off the field here. Big opportunity.
Open. Just couldn't come up with it. He was open.
And a huge play here early. 8:03 to go. Ball's on the 32 of DuBois. 3 receivers to the right. Brooks looking, fires quick, got his man, 1st down. Tackle made by Burkett. Rashad Murray on the receiving end just got about 4 yards. Needed 3, enough to move the chains. 1st down, University Prep.
Just a little curl route, just past the chains. Good 1st down.
So DuBois is going to be forced to make plays on the perimeter. They're going to have to tackle these athletes in space. It's going to be a tough challenge. DuBois has some athletes themselves. First and 10, 28. Brooks, hands straight ahead. Huge hole, 20. Helvey up to the 18, upended by Burkett, getting his second stop of the night. Just going to be just short of a first down. We're talking second and inches here. And early on, USO finding some success.
Up the middle, which I'm surprised about.
Absolutely. DuBois has been stout there all year. Like we said, different opponent tonight. Big challenge here, defensively and offensively. So here we go. Whistles blown here.
So as I sort this out, not sure what's going on here. Referees blew the whistle.
Yeah, it looks like there something might be wrong with Rashawn Murray. Might be bleeding or equipment issue or something. So he didn't look happy going off, but he had to go off. Second and inches here. Brooks throws to the outside, has his man, but he's wrapped up immediately. I don't know if he got the marker. It's going to be very close. I believe he's just going to get enough for it. But very well defended there by Braxton Adams and Ben Hickman. Only needed a half yard, and that's all he got. Ball is on the 18 and a half, sits on the 18. It's going to be a first and 10 for USO.
This might be a fairly easy adjustment for DuBois because I think they're giving a little bit too much respect for the outside, causing the middle to be open, but they can close that door pretty quick.
Trips to the left. Here's a snap. Brooks looking in trouble, and down he goes again. Going to be brought down. Let's see. Braden Rory with the sack. Two sacks so far defensively for the Beavers, and a huge play there on first down. Loss of about six.
That's the epitome of bend, don't break.
So the Beavers defense trying to dig in here. And Holt, this USO drive, their first drive of the game, 5:43 and counting. Trips to the left. Brooks takes a shotgun. He hands it left to Helvey, cuts it back. Breaks one would-be tackler. Gets up across the 20 to the 19. Going to bring up a third down and 11.
Yeah, what was close to a two-yard loss turned out to be a gain almost up to the original line of scrimmage.
Yeah, A.J. Nicastro got good penetration. Helvey looking like a good balanced running back. 5'5", 160. Got some good speed and some shiftiness to him as well. He's been the go-to man early. Three receivers to the right on first down. Brooks hands it to him again, coming right. Cuts it up and not much doing. Gets across the original line of scrimmage. Barely. It's going to be a fourth down and a long nine for USO.
Again, four down territory here without question. But like I was alluding to earlier, they're prepared for that run to the outside.
Absolutely. So here we go. So far, USO 1-for-1 on fourth down. Picked up one earlier this drive. DuBois a chance to get off the field here. Nothing game. 4:25 and counting. Two receivers each side. Brooks, here's a snap. Back to pass, looking, fires. No one home. Incomplete. Beavers take over on down on their own 18-yard line. As we switch possessions, we'll take a quick break. 4:16 to go. Deadlocked at zero. Listening to high school football on Bigfoot Country.
Hi, it's Mike from DeLulo Transport and DuBois. We have immediate openings for local package delivery drivers for our FedEx division. These are non-CDL driving positions. Applicants must be 21 years old, able to lift 100 pounds, have a professional appearance, and must pass a drug test. DeLulo Transport is big enough to deliver, but small enough to care. To apply or find out more, stop by our office at 349 DuBois Street or give us a call at 814-503-4131.
Welcome back to E.J. Mansell Stadium. Braxton Adams, the first down carry, goes nowhere. Brought down by Dante Duncan of USO. No gain on the play, and DuBois so far nothing going offensively.
University Prep has a big push from their defensive line.
Still early, though. DuBois just getting their feet wet. Two receivers each side. Adams is a sidecar. Right. Hayes, the snap. Back looking, dumps it off. Screenplay, Adams, here we go. Got blockers. 25, first down. Goes up to the 30. And he's going to be just shy, marking at the 29. But it's a first down for the Beavers. 12-yard hookup. Hayes to Adams. First down.
Good vision by Adams downfield. He followed his blocker. Had he cut outside, he would have met a defender. He cut inside and got himself 5 more yards.
Yep, set himself nice up there. 29-yard line. Two receivers each side. Caden Clark, Austin Mitchell to the left. Dinkfelt and Burkett to the right. Burkett, the man in motion. Straight ahead with Adams. Tries to bounce it out. And not much doing. Forced out of bounds by Davin Griffin. And corner Rashawn Murray shoved him out of bounds. 2-yard pickup for Adams.
Tough run by Adams. Met helmet to helmet after a 2-yard gain.
Yeah, but you know what? That play was designed inside. You know, Adams did what he could. DuBois has got to stay ahead. Got to stay on schedule. They'll take 2 yards on first down. Hayes back to pass. Looking. Still looking in trouble. Throws. Has a man. Mitchell in traffic. By far, Mitchell's best catch of the season. And it goes for about 14 yards. Cross the 40. To the 42-yard line, first and 10. Nice find by Cameron Hayes.
Yes, it was. And Mitchell did a great job of sliding for that catch.
Used nothing but his hands. That was a great catch. And those are the plays that need to be made in the playoffs. No, it's time. The athletes around Cameron Hayes need to step up. Got another pre-snap penalty down, and it's going to go against USO. Lining up in the neutral zone. Yep. Lining up in the neutral zone. Go 5 yards for the Beavers. 2:47 remaining. First quarter. Beavers have a 1st and 5. Moves the ball now to the 47 of DuBois. No changes offensively. Zach Gallagher, your center. Justin Bangridge, Braden Rory to the right. Mitch Druzak, AJ Nicastro to the left for that offensive line. Hayes is going to keep it up the middle. Big hole cross midfield. Gets to the 48 where he needs for a first down. Should be enough. And it will be another Beaver first down.
Cameron Hayes, a nice job of following his blocker straight up the middle.
Following that offensive line. Offensive line has been stout really all season long. Three receivers to the right. 1st and 10 from the USO 48. They show blitz. They fake it. They dump it off to Adams in the flat. Adams, nice cut. But he's met quickly by the speed of the USO defense. And once again, Davin Griffin there for the stop.
So there was your chess match. They were set up for the screen outside. Not much penetration from the defense.
Flip the formation, three receivers to the left on 2nd and 11. Here's a snap with Hayes. Hayes under trouble, dumps it off. Another screenplay. Here goes Adams. 40, 35, and that'll be another Beaver first down. Let's see here. USO defender thinks he has the ball. He did come up with it, but Adams was out of bounds. Beavers will maintain possession, and it's a 15-yard reception from Adams.
Another good screenplay, and that really opens it up. That's the way you want to control this offense, because that'll open up the run up the middle as well.
Call it 14 yards on that second down play. Beavers going to their senior, Braxton Adams. Pistol set here. Man in motion is Dinkfelt. And here we go. Another pre-snap penalty. Let's see. And once again, lining in the neutral zone twice so far. And we hear a little roar from the DuBois crowd there. They like that penalty. Giving them 5 yards. Moves the ball up to the 30-yard line, 1st and 5.
Nice to get a little help from the opponent.
Absolutely. DuBois putting together a nice drive here. 1:17 to go, first quarter. DuBois looking to get on the board first here in the playoffs. Adams, second back through. Gets what he can. Not much doing up the middle. Maybe a pickup of two. Dante Duncan. And Ramara Terry in on the stop for USO. Bring up a second down and four.
Well, the good thing about that one is it brings up second and three after the penalty, which is what you want to see.
Still second down here. Pistol set. Dalton Yale checks in. A tailback. Austin Henry. Sidecar. Here we go. Straight ahead with Henry. He's going to bounce it to the outside. One man to beat. Can't beat him. No gain on the play. Right read by Henry. But Davin Griffin doesn't let him get to the outside. Third down for the Beavers.
Yeah, if Henry could have had one step on him, he had a lot of running room ahead of him.
Lots of speed for this USO defense. So still right now, DuBois on schedule, and they're going to take the quarter here, and that'll be it. First quarter in the books here for the District 6-8-9 semifinal game here at Mansell Stadium. 0-0 is your score on Bigfoot Country.
Go Beavers! McDonald's and DuBois will be cheering on the Beavers all season long. Don't have time to run and get some food before the game? DuBois McDonald's McDelivery is on DoorDash. Have all your favorites delivered right to your doorstep. Download the DoorDash app and choose your McDonald's menu items for delivery. Simply pay and track your McDelivery order as it comes to you. Getting the food you crave delivered is a whole new way to love McDonald's. You can also grab a treat on your way to the game at your DuBois McDonald's off the beeline.
And we're back at E.J. Mansell Stadium, deadlocked at zero here. Just getting started with the second quarter here. Beavers facing a third and four. So let's check into some other playoff scores around the area over in Brockway at Verschetti Field. Class 3A District 9 championship going on. Clearfield and St. Mary's. Clearfield is up 14-13 with 7:51 to go in the first half. We're about to get underway here for the third down play. We'll get to some other scores when we can. But Clearfield up 14-13 over St. Mary's in that 3A championship. Third and four. Here's Hayes. And Hayes tried the hard count, got his own guy. And that's Henry twice so far today. He'll be the guilty party. And third and nine is a lot tougher than third and four.
Yeah, that's not what you want to have happen right here on third and four. But this may be four down territory.
Yeah, ball sits on the 33. Definitely not in field goal range yet.
No, and if nothing else, we're starting to win the battle of field position.
So here we go. Two receivers each side. Dalton Yale checks in, sidecar right. Dinkfeld coming in motion. Here's a snap. Hayes pivots, rolling right, fires, man open, Burkett, 20, and a first down and ripped down out of bounds late, and we're going to get a flag at 15, probably be half the distance to the goal, so it'll be first and goal from the 10-yard line for the DuBois Beavers, and they're looking to punch six on the board.
Nice spin move there by Cameron Hayes. Spun, rolled right, and his wide receiver was wide open.
And I'm a little surprised to see the corners playing off as much as they are against these DuBois receivers. If you watch film, you know, what have they proven of their downfield passing game? You know, yeah, it's there. They hit something here and there, but it's not like it's crazy consistent. It's not something we, you know, pound, you know, over and over again. You know, something you definitely got to respect from Cameron Hayes. But so far, seen two nice throws from Cameron Hayes on the run tonight.
Yeah, and usually he's about 50% on the run.
So here we go. First and goal from the 10. Two receivers each side. Hayes back looking, rolling left, still rolling, and he's going to take a sack. Brought down. Give credit to Robert Arms, defensive end.
Penalty on the play.
Do have flags down. And it's going to be holding against the Beavers. So once again, not helping our cause out.
No, and that's a spot foul from the 20-yard line. So this is going to end up being first and goal from the 30.
Wow. So you talk about adversity. DuBois has it here. First and goal from the 30. Is it a personal foul from the 20?
Well, not sure how we could spot foul behind the line of scrimmage.
All right. Wow. Not sure who'd be holding 10 yards behind. Here we go. Hayes setting up the screen back. Caden Clark, it's set up. Here goes Clark. 20, 15, 10, 5, dives. Touchdown, Beavers. We got a flag, so hold the phone here. But for the time being, it's a 30-yard touchdown reception. Cameron Hayes to Caden Clark for his first touchdown of his varsity career. They're sorting it out now. Cameron Hayes started rolling right, and they threw the jailbreak left. Jailbreak screen back to the left. Set up beautifully. And Caden Clark used his legs. And it's going to go against the Beavers. It's going to back him up. Legal man downfield. And I think the problem was he didn't catch it beyond the line of scrimmage.
He did catch it beyond the line of scrimmage. Yep, so it wasn't a screen pass. Had he caught it behind the 30, that would have been a legitimate play.
So, yep. Beavers. And I think DuBois is getting another, but they're going to get a 15-yard personal foul here. I think, not sure, by the indication, not sure if it came from the bench or if it was Braxton Adams who was the guilty party who got the flag. But DuBois, you know, and this is what they can't do. You know, they can't let this team get in their head. They can't, you know, play their brand of ball. DuBois just got to be disciplined, not make mistakes, and right now they're playing into their hands, playing the football they want them to play. Going backwards, they got first and goal from midfield.
Yeah, not too often you see first and goal from the 50-yard line.
Now, so DuBois is going to need a big play here. Two receivers each side. Straight ahead with Henry and just nothing doing. Nothing doing in the middle of that USO defense. No gain on the play. It's going to be second and goal from midfield. So what was a very promising looking drive. First and down. Hayes had a nice connection with Burkett. Got a personal foul right after and three straight Beaver penalties. Costing him 40 yards in field position. Three receivers to the right. Here we go. Another screen set, but it's Burkett. Burkett tries to get to the outside and can't. Picks up a couple. Give him a gain of four. It's going to be third and goal from the 46-yard line, a USO.
So they're going to have to take a shot downfield right here.
Yep, and then you'll have to, you know, it's tough, but you'll have to punt on fourth and goal.
Again, something you don't normally see, but we just have to eliminate those mental mistakes. We are moving the ball, which is good.
You know, if you can find 15 yards, maybe you still take a shot at it through the third. But if you don't get anything...
Trips to the left for Hayes. Here's a snap and another. And we're going to get a timeout, the first timeout defensively for USO. We'll take a quick break while they do. Tied at zero with 10-12 to go. Second quarter. You're listening to High School Football on Bigfoot Country.
This is Bigfoot Country.
WIFT DuBois Clearfield. WKFT Strattonville Clarion. This is Bigfoot Country.
This is Bigfoot Country.
We're back at E.J. Mansell Stadium. Still deadlocked at zero. Beavers facing dire circumstances here. Third and goal. Just inside of midfield. Ball sitting on the 46-yard line. So maybe hopefully we get a chunk here. Possibly get in a field goal range maybe. Or maybe just give us a shot. Take a shot in the end zone on fourth down or, you know, something. Maybe give us another play to try to get something in the end zone. But, yeah, not many plays you can draw. Even for, you know, how do you approach first and goal from midfield?
Yeah, try to get 10, 15 yards, maybe 20 yards if you can, and then take a shot. If not, like you say, you may have to punt on fourth and goal.
Yeah, definitely something you don't script up. You don't game plan for that. So, you know, tough to come late calls to set your team up.
But you want to avoid a turnover right here.
Absolutely. Don't add insult to injury. Already making mistakes. Three receivers left. Here's a snap. Hayes back. Hayes looking. He's going to step. Bub's got some room to run. Gets across the 40, 35, 30. So Hayes gets a pretty good chunk. Gets up to the 27-yard line. Called a gain of 19. So we'll see what the Beavers decide to do here. It's going to be fourth down from the 27.
I say this is definitely four down territory here. Take a shot.
Absolutely.
You're not really killing yourself field position wise if you don't make it.
Just know, you know, if you do throw an interception in the end zone, you know, just make sure you get the guy down. Don't let him bring it out. Three receivers left here on fourth down. Hayes back looking. Blitz coming. He's looking. Firing end zone. And it's incomplete. Right through the hands of Mitchell. He had him. Couldn't make the play. Beavers will turn it over to USO.
And Caden Clark was right behind him and almost caught it off the deflection.
Yeah, just maybe a little too tall for Mitchell. Looked like he got his hands there, went through him, and just a little short for Caden Clark. You know, maybe he didn't see Caden Clark, but he was open in the back of the end zone. Score update from Brockway in the 3A championship. Clearfield is now up 21-13 over the Flying Dutchman. So here we go back to the Quad A District 6-8-9 semifinal. 9:57 to go, second quarter. I formation. Flags down.
So a lot of penalties so far in this game.
Absolutely. Seems like we have to have a major discussion for each one, too.
So offsides offense. I mean, you
shouldn't. Lap offsides. Don't see that every day.
No, that's something that should never happen because the outside guys should be checking with the officials on the sideline to make sure they're lined up okay.
Absolutely. Works in the favor of DuBois. First and 15 for USO. Ball's on the 22. I formation once again. Back to passes. Brooks fires, throws, got his man, and there he goes. Oh, shoestring tackle. Derek Burkett saved a touchdown.
Yes, he did. Shoestring tackle, and they almost got to the quarterback.
Yeah, Keon Smalls. Correction. I think I've been calling him Brooks. Keon Smalls is a quarterback for USO.
Yeah, that's a tough pass for a left-handed quarterback thrown to the right. But does get the completion.
Yeah, and he just took a quick three-step drop, fired a slant to Daniel Kane, sophomore wide receiver. Second and four. First back through, spins out of it. He's going to get the first down. Up to about the 39-yard line of USO. They'll have first and 10. Davin Griffin was the ball carrier. Correction. Terrell Allen Tooks on the carry.
There's that name again.
I've only said it twice so far. I could use it a little more. Once again, I formation, first and 10. Helvey dot in the eye. And they're going to toss it to him coming right. He's got the edge, 40, flags thrown, midfield. There he goes, sturdy. Burkett in the chase. Has him down inside the 20. We do have flags down.
Yeah, he got the corner because of a definite hold.
So, a huge gain. Biggest play of the night for both teams. And it will be holding on the offense. So, DuBois gets a break there. Negates a 42-yard carry from Paul Helvey. Sophomore running back who has been the lone spark for the USO offense.
Up the middle and now on the side, but again, this side was sprung by the holding penalty.
Yep, offensive line starting to get comfortable for USO. Got first and 20, though. They're backed up. This DuBois defense is always up for the challenge, have been all year. They won't make it easy. Ball's on the 29-yard line. I formation. Here we go. Back to pass. Throws. Has his man. Adams is there for the tackle. It's going to be a gain of 10. Once again, Keon Smalls to Daniel Kane. Just a quick slant. Picks up 10.
Yeah, that quick slant's there. They run it to perfection. Gains back the yardage they lost on the penalty.
Yep, and now they're right on schedule. Very good play on first down. So here we go. I formation, two receivers each side. Second back through, it's Helvey, and he's going to be stacked up, gets to the 40. Gain of a couple. It's going to bring up third down and 8. Another sophomore, Jason Harris, getting his first carry of the game at the tailback spot.
And that's more of what we're looking for from the DuBois defensive line. They're blocking that run up the middle. Only a gain of 3 on that play.
So here we go. An opportunity for this DuBois defense to get off the field. USO coming out. I formation. Murray is a receiver left. Kane is to the right. Here we go. Smalls back to pass. Looking, plenty of time to throw, does fire, has a man, and it's caught. Very good coverage, just a better catch. On the offensive end, Rashawn Murray hauls in his first grab, good for 15, and a first down.
Yeah, Murray just wanted that more, threw it into double coverage.
Yep, and once again, you know, as tough as Garrett Frantz is, you know, he's got great speed, you know, he can make up, you know, for maybe a first step. False step he can make. He has the speed to correct it. Just Murray has that size on him, but he's tough. He can play with him.
Yeah, he was one step from jumping that route and having a lot of running room for the interception.
So here we go. They're going to give it to the second man through. Gets across the 40. Across the 45, near the 40. Harris again on the carry. Caught a gain of 5 on first down. Ball's on the 41-yard line, 2nd and 5.
And that was a good cut back to the middle. The outside wasn't there, so he cut it back up to the middle, gain 5.
So we've seen a few long drives in this game, both by DuBois and USO. 5:15 counting here. I formation. Helvey's a ball carrier. He's got the outside. There he goes. First down and some more. And add onto it, going to get a face mask against the Beavers. So now USO looking to break bread on the scoreboard first.
That's one of the things you don't expect to see in a playoff game. You would think that the mental mistakes of penalties would be fewer at the end of a regular season. But we had a lot of flags here tonight.
Yeah, especially at this point. And, you know, DuBois games have been worse. But a team that really hasn't been bothered a whole lot by penalties, you know, they've gotten as average penalty as most teams. But it's not like they're, you know, crazily defected by, you know, penalties night in and night out. You know, they're a pretty disciplined team on that end, on that aspect of the game. But so far tonight,
two personal fouls is not good.
Yep, they're paying some dividends. I formation again. Smalls rolling out. Fires looking end zone. And it's picked off. Burkett. I believe he did. Let's wait on the call. And he did. He picked it off with one hand. And an unbelievable play. Bam. The first turnover of the game. The senior safety, Derek Burkett. An unbelievable one-handed interception in the back of the end zone.
Great athleticism by Burkett. Pulls that down one-handed. I think he got both feet in.
Unbelievable. And a key to victory today was this team making big plays. Offensively, it's the guys around Cameron Hayes. Cameron Hayes himself has to play well tonight, has to be accurate, but the guys around him have to help him out as well. A lot of drops this season. Got to help him out. That's a big play. Defense coming up big. First and 10 from the 20. Pistol set. Here we go. Second back through is Yale. Yale bounces it to the outside. Breaks off a tackle. Carries it across the 30 to the 31. And a first down carry for Dalton Yale.
Yeah, so far, some of the DuBois losses in the regular season were just one or two little things going against DuBois. Now, hopefully, we've got it going the other way in the playoffs.
Yep, and it's plays like that. One-handed interception in the back of the end zone can give a team momentum at any point in the game. Tied at zero, 5:06 to play. We have whistles and another USO timeout. Their second of the half. They'll have one remaining. We'll take a quick timeout as well. DuBois driving here, 5:06 to go. Your score is 0-0.
Out-of-town guests coming in for a reunion, celebration, or family function? Make them feel at home at the DuBois Hampton Inn. Group rates are available for your guests, and a clean, comfortable room is a promise. Meeting and banquet rooms are available. Enjoy the indoor pool, hot tub, and we have wireless internet, too. Start your day right with the Hamptons' free hot breakfast. Call us, 814-375-1000. That's 814-375-1000. The DuBois Hampton Inn. We love having you here.
0-0 is your score with 5:06 to go in the first half. Kind of a fast-moving first half, John. Like I said, DuBois, this is just their second possession. USO has two. DuBois has two. Correction, this is their third possession. They started with the ball. But, yeah, it's been a fast pace. Teams are keeping it on the ground. Both sides. So far, both defenses have been pretty stout. Haven't given up nothing. DuBois looking to change that. They're driving here. Ball's on the 32-yard line.
And like you were saying, this is TJ's game plan. He wants to keep it on the ground, control the clock.
So here we go. Pistol set again on first down. Dingfelt in motion. Once again, Dalton Yale straight through. Not much doing there. Up the middle once again. Dominic Asamoah and the stop for USO. Second down and nine. Here we go. Hayes rolling to the right. Hayes throws low, intended for Burkett, and incomplete. So Hayes had a man in his face there. Kanye Henderson, defensive end, came off the edge, was right in the face of Hayes when he delivered that football, caused it to fall short of Burkett.
Yeah, and I'm not so sure. He didn't just throw it at his ankles because it was well defended on the play as well.
Third and nine, three receivers to the right. Big third down for DuBois. Flags down pre-snap once again. So let's see here, and before, well, not sure here, timeout is the call. Not sure why the flags came out, but USO called another timeout. We'll take one as well. 4:30 to go. 0-0 is your score at Mansell.
When plowing is your profession, it's up to you to keep the world moving through winter's worst. Less time worrying about your equipment is more time for clearing lots. So we'll cut to the chase. Only Western builds efficiency into every feature of our plows and spreaders. With more than 65 years of experience behind us, Western knows what it takes to take on all the depths of winter. More jobs done faster. See your local Western dealer, Tri-County Performance, Beaver Drive, DuBois.
Third and nine from the DuBois 32-yard line. USO used their third and final timeout. With 4:30 remaining, deadlocked at zero here in this district sub-region semifinal game. District 6, 8, and 9. University Prep from District 8. DuBois representing District 9 in Quad A here tonight. On the other side of our sub-region bracket in Mifflintown tonight, Bellefonte Red Raiders travel to take on Juniata High School. Winners will play each other next week for the district title. Here we go. Quads to the right. Hayes rolling on third down throws. Has a man, Dingfelt, open in the middle of the field. Just across midfield into USO territory on the 49-yard line. Hayes finding Dinkfeld. First down.
Great poise by Cameron Hayes because he actually bobbled the snap. Had enough wherewithal to roll to the right after he bobbled it and found Dinkfeld wide open in the middle.
Absolutely. A new look there. Quads to the right there in a diamond set for the Beavers. Clock's moving. Just outside. Four to go. Two receivers each side. Hayes back. Goes up the middle. Quarterback draw. Tries to get to the outside. Does. Lowers his shoulder. Fighting for yardage. And I'll tell you what, that's a type of play right there that makes you want to play for Cameron Hayes. And a couple extracurriculars is going to go against USO. Still talking, and that DuBois Beavers bench is fired up. And they might be discussing a being thrown here. It I believe
like that's what happened, and if that's the case, that he should be ejected.
Yep, I believe that's a PIW as well. It was Amir McLeod, I believe. It's the personal foul. And number eight, it is a personal foul on Amir McLeod, and he is ejected for throwing a punch. He threw it at AJ Nicastro. Probably not the smartest guy to punch, but I'll tell you what, DuBois will take it, and yeah, here we go. No kind of chippiness from both sides here. It's going DuBois' favor now. Now let's capitalize here. 24-yard line, first and 10. Let's go. Two receivers each side. A game dominated by defense so far. 3:53 to go. This 2021 squad trying to make history here tonight, John. Trying to get the program's first playoff win in quite some many years.
I'm not really even sure when they won their last playoff game.
I think I have an idea, but I don't know exactly, so I don't want to say it and be wrong because I'm not 100% sure. Over 20 years, I know that. Two receivers each side, first and 10. Here's Hayes, pump fake, screen set up, Burkett, here he goes, 15. Derek Burkett, 10. He's got a first down, mark him down at the 11. It's a gain of 13. And first and 10, and the Beavers are rolling here. 3:30 and counting.
USO's leaving that screen open on the outside.
Absolutely. Starting to load the box, blitzing their linebackers in this second quarter. DuBois is taking advantage of it. We're going to have a timeout from the officials, letting a USO player get his mouthpiece in the DuBois backfield. Allows USO to do a late substitution. Getting Kanye Henderson back in at defensive end. He's been in the backfield a little bit. Two receivers each side. Here's Hayes. Hayes back to pass. Quarterback draw set up. Here it goes. 10, 5, touchdown. Cameron Hayes. DuBois on the board first here. 6-0 over USO. 11 yards out.
And that right there is what that screenplay does for you. It up the middle for that quarterback draw.
Yep, and Coach Wingert is mixing it up a lot tonight. No, we're coming out, doing what we do, trying to establish line of scrimmage, get the run game going. It's not working out. Throwing some scenes. We're taking some shots. Quarterback draws. Using Hayes' legs to perfection there. 11 yards out. On the board first. Good snap. Good hold. Kick is up. And it is no good. It's wide to the left. So Charlie Harmon misses his second PAT of the year with 3:01 to go. Hayes makes it 6-0. DuBois over USO on Bigfoot Country.
Buying or selling a home does not have to be difficult. Hi, I'm Brian Leach, Realtor, Hoffer Realty. I'm ready to help you. Let us show you how easy the whole process can be. Call me at Hoffer Realty and we can get started. Let me show you the way home.
Voted best realtor in the Tri-County for the last 2 years. Find Brian on Facebook at Brian Leach Realtor or at Hoffer Realty in DuBois by calling 814-371-2100. That's 814-371-2100.
Cameron Hayes gets the scoring started late in the first half. 3:01 to go. Finds the end zone from 11 yards out on a quarterback draw. Charlie Harmon unable to convert the PAT. So it is 6-0 in favor of the Beavers here in the district. semifinal playoff game.
Now's where DuBois has some work to do. With 3:01 left, they've got to stop this drive because USO gets the ball in the second half. So yep. They need to stop two drives here.
Charlie Harmon set to kick. Amir Gee back deep. And it's a quick squib, and it's fallen on by USO wisely. DuBois was in pursuit. Jumped on by Khalil Bird, 5'6", 195-pound sophomore for USO. Saves what could have been disastrous for USO. Charlie Harmon, same approach, did that line drive squib, and it caught an up man.
It did. Bounced right towards the DuBois defenders, but luckily a player for USO jumped on it before they got there.
Yeah, and you know, on the downside of the lack of being able to kick it end-to-end, you know, USO gets decent field position here. Ball sitting on the 33-yard line for their first and 10 here with 2:59 to go. Plenty of time and good field position. Here we go, two receivers each side. Smalls in the shotgun. Harris, sidecar right. Here's a snap. Looking, stepping up. He's going to take off. McDowell throws him down. Ball comes out late. Let's see here. DuBois is pointing their way. Ball came out. Looked like he was down, and yeah, they're going to call him down. And I thought he was down on the live play, John. He looked down at me.
Yeah, I think his knees hit the ground before the ball ever came out.
Yeah, absolutely. Clock rolling, 2:40 and counting. McDowell will be credited with the tackle there. 8 yards on first down. Second down and two. Smalls in the gun. Here's the snap. It's going to be a draw straight up the middle. There goes Harris. Huge hole. 40. Beavers territory, 35. And that's where he's brought down by Ben Hickman. And it's a huge gain into Beaver territory. 35-yard line, first down. Uncommon
gain. But again, DuBois playing that bend, don't break defense. You had to know they're probably going to gain some yards. Now we need to buckle down and stop this drive.
Yep, we've seen DuBois rise up plenty this season in late weeks. Very capable. Two receivers each side. Smalls throws quickly. Has a man. It's Kane. Makes one man miss and is brought down by Benjamin. Picks up about 7 yards. Caught 6 yards on first down. Smalls to Kane.
And now with no timeouts, 1:40 to go, USO's, you got to worry about the clock a little bit here.
1:30 to go. Clock rolls out of timeouts. Here we go. Smalls looking, going, end zone, has a man, and it's caught. No, incomplete. It's incomplete. Once again, he had it and was unable to control it to the ground. I believe the ground played a huge effect in dislodging that football.
It did. He was behind the defender. He was open for that catch, just couldn't come up with it.
Yeah, DuBois is going to have to take a look at that matchup. That is a huge mismatch for them. Tailback Paul Helvey on Ben Hickman. That's not a matchup. DuBois wants to, you know, exploit out there because Helvey had some steps on Hickman. Here we go. He's split out again. DuBois will take their first timeout. We'll take one with him with 1:18 to go. DuBois 6, USO 0.
We are here for you. Hi, this is Bill Drahushak of DuBois Drug and Wellness. Seniors who need medication and those who are unable to leave their homes no longer have to drive, wait in line, or worry about missing their dosage. We offer free delivery 6 days a week and free medication packaging. DuBois Drug and Wellness is dedicated to helping you and everyone in the community stay healthy. Call us at 371-5827 or visit us at www.dubuoisdrug.com for more details. DuBois Drug and Wellness, your community, your health, your pharmacy.
.118 remaining, first half, 6-0 DuBois leading here. USO trying to tie or take the lead here before halftime. They have 3rd and 4 from the 30. Need the 26-yard line to continue. Probably 4-down territory. 2 receivers each side. Helvey's in the slot right. Here's the snap. Going to be another draw. Harris is through, and I believe he got the first down. Broke out of one initial tackle, had him in the backfield, was able to slip out of it. It's going to be a first down up to the 25-yard line for USO.
DuBois needs to pay attention to that. He is telegraphing that play. That running back takes a step back.
Another pre-snap penalty here. USO trying to go quick. Should be on USO. Officials coming over to talk to Coach Wingard. And this will be against USO, just waiting the official call. False start on the offense. It'll back them up five.
Set up first and 15.
First and 15, ball back to the 30-yard line. Clock winds, under a minute to go. Two receivers each side for Smalls. Here's a snap, rolling to his left, throws in the flat, incomplete. Bring up second and 15. Pass was intended for senior receiver Rashad Murray. So let's see if this DuBois defense can rise up again. Big here. 48 seconds to go. First half. This time intended for Rashawn Murray on the other side of the field. Going to bring up third down. And the DuBois defense starting to tighten up a little on the outside.
Yeah, forcing him to roll. And that's an odd throw for a quarterback on the run.
Yeah, and we've talked about it, John. You know, a 2-5 record, you know, shouldn't be in the playoffs. You know, ideally, you know, that can't get you in, but just the circumstances they are in, they put in. And what that tells DuBois is they think they can come in and beat you here tonight. Third and 15, here's the snap. Smalls throwing over the middle, complete Helvey. And I believe that's enough for a first down. Needed 15, got 16. Ball's on the 14-yard line. First and 10. USO, chance still to tie or take the lead. 30 seconds and counting, no timeouts. Here's a snap. Smalls throws in the flats, incomplete. Not sure who the intended receiver was. Trying to get a jersey. Believe the intended target was Daniel Kane. Fall short of him once again. Second down and 10 from the 14-yard line. Two receivers each side. Here we go, the snap. Balls, looking, throwing, looking, end zone, caught. No, he's short. Caught the ball. He's well short of the end zone. Got a little excited there. So I believe it will be enough for another first down.
And he was out of bounds, so that stops the clock.
Yep. Stops the clock, 19.6. So we got a timeout again on the field. DuBois wants to talk about their go-to-go situation. While they break, we will too. 19.6 to go. DuBois leads 6-0.
DuBois High School football in Bigfoot Country brought to you by DeLillo Transport, a family-owned and operated company providing reliable transportation services with headquarters in DuBois. Interested in joining the DeLillo team? Call 814-503-4131. Stop by the office, 349 DuBois Street, or visit DeLilloTransport.com. By DuBois Burger King, visit DuBois Burger King for a hot and delicious sausage or bacon, egg, and cheese croissant sandwich. Get two for just $4. By Eastern Environmental Industries, whether it's transportation hauling or container rentals, Eastern Environmental Industries in Brockway has you covered. Take the wheel and join their growing company, EastEnviro.com.
Back at EJ Mansell Stadium, first and goal for USO. 19.6 seconds. If DuBois can hold him here, it'll be tough for him to get a playoff. USO's going to have to hurt. I formation. Harris is the tailback. Smalls looking for the end zone, and it's incomplete, and flags are down. And you're gotta assume that's going to be holding or some sort of pass interference against DuBois.
Yeah, I think when he made the move, we might have grabbed him. But
didn't see a whole lot of grabbing going on there. John Murray did kind of do a baseball turn, made a little adjustment to that ball late. And it is going to be, was it pass interference or holding?
I think they called holding on that. Oh, pass interference.
Thanks to our Mega Rock crew. Confirmed the call. Pass interference on Braxton Adams. First and goal from the one. Second back through. Matt Christian Kirk makes a stop. Clock's rolling 10 seconds. They're going to have to hurry. 8 seconds. No timeout. 5, 4, 3, snap. And they spike it with a minute. I'm sorry. 1.5 ticks to go.
Penalty.
There is a penalty. False start. False start against USO. If it's on USO... Okay, prior to the snap, 5-yard penalty, 1.5 to go. Clock will wind, and yep, that play will continue to run, and DuBois is going to go into the half with a score of 6-0. Christian Kirk with a huge stop came untouched on that second and goal attempt. An unbelievable way to end the half. And like I said, Christian Kirk, so far with the play of the night, a huge stop.
And USO coaches want an explanation as to why they started that clock. They were in a huddle on the sideline when the referees started that clock. But again, the play never happened as a false start. It should have been on the whistle.
Yep, absolutely. That's why the clock winded once we resumed play and the ball got set. Once again, Christian Kirk coming up big to end our first half. Beavers on top, 6-0 over University Prep. Stay tuned for our halftime show with Chuck Farah, as always. And you've been listening to High School Football on Bigfoot Country.
Hello, everyone. Jeffrey from Brackman Chevrolet Buick in Punxsutawney. We are huge advocates of youth sports. Without coaches and all the helpers, it wouldn't be possible. The teamwork, camaraderie, goal setting, the learning how to deal with disappointment. These are all skills that our children are learning by being involved in youth athletics, but it wouldn't be possible without these coaches and staff. So when you see them, shake their hand, say thank you for making a sacrifice for our kids, because they are helping give our next generation of leaders the skills they need to succeed. And remember, Chevys cost less in Punxsy. Hello, everyone. Jeffrey from Brackman Chevrolet Buick in Punxsutawney. We are huge advocates of youth sports. Without coaches and all the helpers, it wouldn't be possible. The teamwork, camaraderie, goal setting, the learning how to deal with disappointment. These are all skills that our children are learning by being involved in youth athletics, but it wouldn't be possible without these coaches and staff. So when you see them, shake their hand, say thank you for making a sacrifice for our kids, because they are helping give our next generation of leaders the skills they need to succeed. And remember, Chevys cost less in Punxsy.
Welcome back from our first half action, ladies and gentlemen. It's time for the Brackman Chevrolet of Punxsutawney halftime show. Devin Clark, as always, with athletic director Chuck Farah. This is playoff edition of our halftime show. Just in case you guys forgot, it is playoff time. We're very excited about it. So, Coach, we'll get right into it here. Most of the regular seasons are in the rear view, if not all of it. It's playoff time. We've got a lot of teams competing, playoff eligible. So let's start there. You know, how are the teams doing? You know, kind of keep us up. Have teams are advancing further on? Are some teams eliminated? How are we doing in the playoffs?
Yeah, we're doing pretty good so far. I think I mentioned previous weeks, you know, golf's been done for a while. Both our boys and girls teams won district team titles there. Tennis finished up a couple weeks ago. They lost in the sub-regional to Erie McDowell. This past week, boys soccer, they lost their District 9 playoff game to Clearfield. The girls soccer team was in the district finals against Bradford on Monday, and they lost 3-0 there. Cross country, last Saturday, they were at Ridgeway. The boys were at Ridgeway. They won their second straight District 9 AA title. The entire team will move on. That includes AC Deemer, Joey Fordora, Ryan White, Reed Williams, Jaden Yaris, Christian Romer, Luke Sturrock, and the all-winning Chase Hook. The girls finished second and third. They were in the District 8, 9, 10 sub-regional Titusville. We had three girls moving on there. Morgan Romer, Sydney Beers, and Morgan King will all qualify for state. So we have, you know, 11 kids who are moving on to states and cross-country, which is great. Volleyball played this week. Earlier this week, they play Clearfield on Wednesday for the district title game. And then, of course, we have football tonight. So that's where we're at with everything.
Yeah, a lot of good things going on. A lot of teams in the postseason. A lot of success. Teams still playing. You know, so you mentioned some teams have been eliminated from contention, but, you know, it says a lot to just even get to that point. So just once again, across the board, you know, soccer, cross country,
girls volleyball, just everybody who's been competing tennis, just congratulations on the success you've had this fall sports. Now, Coach, Chuck, we have a lot of football to discuss today for our show, so let's start here with looking forward, despite things go our way, against university preps. So how's the sub-region going to play out, and then what is going to be next for DuBois going forward?
So how the sub-region plays out, we're the District 9 representative. We're playing the District 8 representative, who's university prep out of the Pittsburgh City League. On the other side of the bracket is District 6, which is Juniata is playing host to Bellefonte. So we'll play the winner of that next week, either Friday or Saturday night. It'll be at a neutral site. Should we win the game, I'm guessing we'll play somewhere between Bellefonte, Bald Eagle, Hollidaysburg, Altoona, somewhere in that range probably will be the host site. Then after that winner then will represent the South Sub-Regional moving forward, and we'll play the District 10 champion, which looks to be probably at this point Meadville. Looks to be the best team out of that league there. Then that team moves on, further in the state playoffs. I think gets the District 4, District 11 winner, and then you face the Whitfield champ at 7, and eventually to the state finals there.
Yeah, thanks for just kind of breaking that down a little, Chuck. Just kind of give people listening who aren't, because there's a lot of kind of hoopla going on with all these sub-regions and, not having enough teams in your district. So, just thanks for kind of explaining that a little further. And, no doubt, but it's going to get tougher as you go down the line here. So, it's been a while. We'll throw out some numbers here for you. 4 years since DuBois has been in the playoffs last 2017. Mm-hmm. And getting, into some more fun information, it's been 10 years since 2011 we've hosted a playoff game. So, how excited are you for football to be back in the playoffs?
Oh, it's as a football guy myself, obviously, it's really exciting. As the AD, obviously, I'm really looking forward to seeing our team back in the playoffs. That means we're heading in the right direction, which I firmly believe we are. So, yeah, it's going to be great atmosphere, I think, Friday night, and really looking forward to it.
So how about the home game? Does that make it just more special
that's
from your standpoint?
Sure, it makes it even more special. We thought we were done on senior night, and we told we got a home game, so that's one added bonus for the kids. The kids probably are looking forward to that home game, and that's what it's all about.
Yeah, and that's something, not a lot of players have come through over the years have experienced. So, I know Coach has these guys really focused in, and these kids are ready to accept this challenge, this opportunity they have coming forward. So, different type of opponent that they're going to be playing from the City League. I guess we'll call them the City League champ, I guess, if you want to say. 2-5 record, don't know how that's possible. But this is still going to be a different type of opponent for these kids.
Yeah.
So how big of a challenge, does DuBois present themselves right now?
Yeah, I mean, every game's a challenge at this point. I mean, I know they're 2-5, but, it can be very dangerous. We don't have any common opponents, so not much you can go by other than just looking at some film and going from there. And, we've played City League teams in the past. They're always very athletic. Maybe not as physical as the schools we play up here, but, we've got to be careful with that. I think if we play our game we've been playing all year, which is being physical and tough and winning the line of scrimmage battle, I think we should be fine just to limit the big plays. That's all.
Yeah, a big thing me and Coach Winger talked about was, just don't give them anything. Don't play into their hands. Don't stoop down to how they want to play. Take care of your business. Don't make mistakes. Take care of the football. That's going to be huge.
Definitely. That's always going to be the key.
And that's all time we have for the Brackman Chevrolet Punxsutawney Halftime Show. You're listening to Bigfoot Country.
Hello, everyone. Jeffrey from Brackman Chevrolet Buick in Punxsutawney. We are huge advocates of youth sports. Without coaches and all the helpers, it wouldn't be possible. Teamwork, camaraderie, goal setting, the learning how to deal with disappointment. These are all skills that our children are learning by being involved in youth athletics, but it wouldn't be possible without these coaches and staff. So when you see them, shake their hand, say thank you for making a sacrifice for our kids, because they are helping give our next generation of leaders the skills they need to succeed. And remember, Chevys cost less than Punxy. Hello, everyone. Jeffrey from Brackman Chevrolet Buick in Punxsutawney. We are huge advocates of youth sports. Without coaches and all the helpers, it wouldn't be possible. The teamwork, camaraderie, goal setting, the learning how to deal with disappointment. These are all skills that our children are learning by being involved in youth athletics, but it wouldn't be possible without these coaches and staff. So when you see them, shake their hand, say thank you for making a sacrifice for our kids, because they are helping give our next generation of leaders the skills they need to succeed. And remember, Chevys cost less than Punxy.
Welcome back to EJ Mansell Stadium. Still at halftime here. Got 7:20 on the clock. Band's out. rocking this stadium right now for playoff football in DuBois. You know, John, let's just kind of talk about this atmosphere a little bit tonight. You know, it's been a while. You know, it's nice to have playoff football back here in DuBois at AJ Mansell Stadium.
It is, and a shout out to those listening on Facebook and watching on YouTube. We definitely want to give a shout out to them. A lot of people listening here tonight.
Yeah, absolutely. And last weekend, Kern City, you know, we had our biggest attendance, you know, on our Facebook feed watching the game. So once again, thank you to all you guys tuning in and listening and watching here. Very much appreciated on the behalf of Bigfoot Country. So, John, you know, we got some first half notes to go over here. I don't know, 6-0, DuBois leading USO here. A defensive battle, you know, to kind of start. You know, it was chippy, a lot of penalties both ways, some personal fouls, a lot of pre-penalties. But DuBois was able to take advantage of the first opportunity. USO making mistakes just as much as them. DuBois was able to take advantage first.
They did, and DuBois did their job on that last drive. With USO getting the ball to end the first half, and then again to start the first half, they really needed to keep them from putting points on the board there.
Yeah, and the DuBois defense made a couple huge plays in that second quarter, halting two USO drives, you know, long drives, you know, that were chewing up clock. Derek Burkett makes a huge interception in the back of the end zone, one-handed, to turn it over that led to, I believe, the Cameron Hayes score. Yes, it did. So DuBois able to turn a takeaway into points. You know, that's huge, man. At this point in the playoffs, you know, that's good stuff. You know, that's a recipe to win. And right before the half, USO driving. Christian Kirk makes a huge play. Time dwindling. USO scrambles to the line. Got the false start. And that and eventually ended up ending the first half.
It is, and that's a big statistic, points on turnover. That was a great catch, a one-handed grab by the DuBois defender that set up that drive.
And so, yeah, DuBois has the advantage here. We have 24 minutes left of football here tonight at EJ Mansell Stadium. Sadly, no matter win or lose tonight, you know, we won't have another game here at EJ Mansell Stadium. So it's nice for the kids, but, you know, just to bring the playoff atmosphere back here, you know, to a program that has a lot of history, kind of fell off from tradition the last few years. Coach Wingard's got them back going in the right direction in the playoffs here tonight. And they're, like I mentioned, 24 minutes away from taking home a playoff win.
They are. These kids are hungry for that. I think if you ask them, they'll sacrifice the win to go on the road. I'm sure they'll be willing to go on the road.
Yeah, and Coach has told me, you know, he has a good senior class, you know, a great or group of kids in that senior class, good upper classmen as well, along with the junior class, a lot of numbers in the 11th grade on this football team. So lots looking forward in that, right? But, yeah, the final thoughts from Coach, I mentioned them. Before kickoff, you know, they just had the right mentality. You know, they put together good practices this week. They really got after it. They know the opportunity. They understand what's at stake, and they've accepted the challenge. Now it's all about finishing 24 minutes ago.
It is. They settled in. You can see the jitters in their first drive. The jitters are gone. They've settled in. Now they're on this.
Absolutely. And we're going to take a quick break here, and when we bring it back, we'll have more halftime show for you. But for the time being, we'll send it back to the station. 6-0 here at halftime.
DuBois Beaver High School football in Bigfoot Country is brought to you by Community-Wide Construction. No job is too large or too small. Residential or commercial, remodeling, the building your dream home, quality, craftsmanship, and attention to details. Community-Wide Construction of DuBois. Phone 375-9559. Next Tier Bank, your community bank. Liberty Boulevard, DuBois, proud to support our student athletes. Visit us at nexttierbank.com. And by Subway of DuBois, fresh is what we do. Build a delicious sandwich, plus get a free cookie every Sunday at Subway. Three locations inside the DuBois Walmart at the DuBois Mall and South Brady Street. Go Beavers.
And welcome Welcome back to EJ Mansell Stadium. District 6-8-9 sub-regional semifinal game going on here tonight. DuBois Beavers and the University Prep, as we mentioned, University Prep combined as well with SciTech Obama Academy from inner city Pittsburgh out of District 8. And DuBois represents District 9, the lone Quad 8 team in all of the district. So just continuing to recap our first half here, John. DuBois started off with the ball. Like I said, got the jitters out of the way, turned into a three and out. And then it three possessions. Each team was that first half. You know, each team had long drives, two long drives for each team, keeping things on the ground, keeping the clock moving. And, you know, like we said, things got a little chippy. So I think keys, you know, for both teams, you know, we'll look at more on USO side. You know, they need to get more discipline pre-snap and after the snap. You know, they have a kid ejected in this game already. DuBois does have more personal fouls, so they're winning in that aspect. Not a category you want to be winning in if you're DuBois. So, yeah, still, we'll go back to USO. Need to be more disciplined, and they just need to take what DuBois, you know, give them, go back to the ground game, and they're playing off maybe, you know, go to some quick game. I think they're trying a little too much on offense, trying to force the ball downfield. DuBois has answered the bell on the back end.
They have, and you can tell USO has come in here with something to prove. Like you mentioned in the first half, you know, even at a 2-5 record, they came in here expecting to beat this Beaver team.
Absolutely, and another thing that's helping for this DuBois defense is they're getting pressure. You know, they're getting a key on Smalls. They've gotten to